I like you. Love. I think the most memorable thing, I know this is probably materialistic, but I don't care. You guys have one of the coolest vintage shops out there. It's like a appointment only place. It's called Dum Dum Showroom, and it's really, really cool. It's owned by this Korean couple, I believe, and they were really, really kind and let us shop in this really cool store. They had like 80s vintage hip hop t-shirts and like action figures. It was really cool. I think my cooking skills are trash, but actually when it comes to, you know, teriyaki chicken and some rice, I feel like I could do that because it's pretty simple for me. I'm not saying it's the best, but it gets the job done for my stomach. I will say I haven't cooked in the past 6 to 8 months. I've been working on this album and I just kind of, I just gave up on it after quarantine, really. I should probably get back into it though. I think for us, when we wanted to shoot the Charmander video, we had a couple of ideas, me and Jack, and we liked them, but it was a little hard to get these ideas finished because of the time constraint that we had in order to put this video out. So I was kind of stuck on ideas, and to be honest with you, I just read the lyrics of the song and I took a shroom, and we came up with this crazy idea to just kind of do it in this one home and keep the location very simple. I think for a lot of my videos, we kind of resort to doing like multiple locations, and this go around, we kind of wanted to challenge ourselves and see if we could make a video that was just as entertaining, but as simple as one location. And it saved us a lot of time and gave us a lot more time to be creative with the shots. So that was cool. To be honest with you, I'm not a huge anime like stan, but growing up, Yu-Gi-Oh and Pokemon cards were like, you know, the thing to die for. So I always had a Charmander on me. And I think the way we titled the song was just because Lito asked me my favorite Pokemon character. So it wasn't even like I had a plan to call Charmander Charmander. I think it was, we just wanted to choose our favorite, Pokemon. And it was the fire one, so it just kind of made sense with it being a rap song. You know, the shit is fire. So, Parasite was just incredible because, I mean, everyone loves that movie. But I think for me, it was incredible because I learned right afterwards that the whole set was, like, built for the movie. That wasn't, like, some place they found. That was, like built to be very particular to the movie and the things that the director wanted. And I really appreciated that because I was like, this, it just made sense. It was really, really cool. And the comedy element in this, like, huge, huge, serious drama about poverty and capitalism in general, it was just really cool to see that on film.
Have you seen the other well-known Korean movie, Minari?
I have seen Minari. I really related to Minari because, you know, my parents came to America in search of a better life and in search of better jobs. And to see that, you know, struggle for the family in Minari was something I really related to. And I thought it was dope to see that portrayed on film. I think I personally gravitate more towards films about immigrants coming to America all the time because I just relate to it. So, oh, I love Squid Game. Squid Game is crazy. My favorite part is Bro's red hair at the end. I just need an explanation as to why he dyed his hair red. Does that mean something in particular, or he was just trying to swag out? Like, I don't know. I thought it was sick though. And the film had me like sweating in my bed watching it. It was very, very dramatic. And again, Korea is just killing it in film. It's really cool that people think Limbo is one of the best albums. The Grammys didn't think so. but for me, Limbo just means, it's more like a personal journey for me. It was something that for me really fulfilled something that I wanted to do. A classic like hip hop album. was something I felt like I hadn't truly made yet. You know what I mean? Good For You and 1.5 are hip hop albums, but they also bend more in the pop and trap elements of hip hop. And for me, I wanted to make something that was a little bit more classic bending. And yeah, it fulfilled everything I wanted. And I don't know, I'm just really proud of that project. Pasquay, one of my like head producers and executive producers, he would make me playlists of just random songs that I've never heard in my life, and I would just listen to those, and I would listen to a bunch of just new stuff that my parents used to always play, but I completely forgot about. So I was just trying to like listen to just stuff that I never would listen to on the usual and on the regular. So I was just trying to change my habits when it came to making new music after Limbo. I was trying to take new drugs. I was trying to meet new people. I was trying to have new meals. Just like completely kind of have like a 180 of my process and lifestyle during Limbo. You know what I mean? I think when you're making a new album, it isn't just the music that needs to change. It's kind of like everything for me. It's including like everything, food, music, friends, all that. Not saying I'm gonna dump my old friends, just meeting new people. I'm really enjoying Little Sims' new album. I think it's beautiful, and I think, you know, it has this, I don't know, kind of realness about it, and it feels true to her. So that's what I really enjoyed about it. I haven't felt like I've listened to too many new albums that made me feel like it was true to the artists and what they wanted, and that's what Little Sims' album sounds like to me, and that's why I enjoy it. If you're Korean and you like Aminé, I like you. Love.